Up next on the Hornet Sports Report, the ASU fall teams are on the roll. Football has won 4 in a row. Volleyball has posted 7 straight victories. Soccer has won 4 in a row. And the ASU cross-country team won its most recent meet. All this and more up next on the Alabama State University Hornet Sports Report. Hello and welcome to this week's edition of the Hornet Sports Report. ASU football has won its 4th consecutive game last week over Texas Southern by a score of 34-2. Joined now by head coach Reggie Barlow. And Coach Barlow, once again, your offense set the tone in victory.
We were very proud of our offense. We knew going into Texas Southern on the road that we wanted to get off to a really good start. Offensively, we were able to do that. We've been consistent running the football. We were able to establish the run with Malcolm Sires, Isaiah Crowell, and Rodney Cross, which ultimately opened up some passing lanes for us and was able to make some big plays from Duhart to DeMario Bell. So, once again, offense got off to a really good start. Our defense also played well. Whenever you can shut a team out, that's a positive thing. Of course, we gave up a safety there at the end to give up 2 points. But all in all, a good effort by all three phases.
And talk a little more about your defense. Allowed just 185 total yards.
Our defense, Coach Ramsey, going back to Texas Southern, where he was the head coach, and our guys really bought into the plan that he had put forth for us. And our defensive line was played really well. Derek Billups and Big Country there, those guys played outstanding. Linebackers were running all over the place and just being real combative and physical. And whenever you can limit a team to that amount of yards, it's going to be a positive thing. And of course, that's really what allowed us to get the victory.
And not just last week against Texas Southern, but during this winning streak, they forced 12 takeaways.
Whenever you can win a turnover battle, it's going to give you an opportunity to win the game. Win the turnover battle and be able to rush the ball, that's a good combination for wins. And we pride ourselves on getting turnovers, and in that game we were able to get some loose balls. We got to the quarterback a bunch in that game, some hurries, was able to get some sacks, was able to take them and put them in a lost yard situation. So just an all-out positive performance by our defensive team. And, you know, it's definitely something that we can continue to build on.
Let's take a look at last week's highlights versus Texas Southern. So Alabama State football improves to 4-2 overall, 4-1 in swag play. We'll talk about this weekend's matchup versus Prairie View, but up next, we'll talk Lady Hornet volleyball. You're watching the Hornet Sports Report. Follow the Hornets wherever you are. Get the latest news on the official website at BamaStateSports.com. Plus, download our free mobile apps for Android and iPhone. And follow us on social media on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Visit BamaStateSports.com/social media. Hornet Pride 365 is a new giving campaign aimed to support Alabama State Athletics. For just $1 a day, you can make the difference in the lives of our student athletes. For more information and to make a donation, visit BamaStateSports.com/HornetPride365.
Helping wounded heroes start anew, creating new DNA technologies to help keep our communities safe. If you haven't seen ASU lately, you haven't seen ASU. Alabama State University has expanded academic opportunities with new degrees in forensic chemistry, prosthetics and orthotics, applied technology, and microbiology. ASU students and faculty are at the forefront of cutting-edge research that is changing lives. If you haven't seen ASU lately, you haven't seen ASU.
The hard work. The sweat. Pain. It all comes down to this. Who will rise as others fall? Who will lead victorious? Houston will never be the same. Catch the Battle of the Bands and the 2013 Toyota SWAC Football Championship. Who will be victorious on Judgment Day?
Welcome back to the Hornet Sports Report. ASU volleyball has reeled off 7 consecutive wins, including 4 in last weekend's Southern University tournament. Joined now by head coach Penny Lucas White. And Coach White, you had to be pleased with the way your ladies played last weekend.
I'm very pleased. They really went in. They were on a mission, and they competed very well.
You talked about this mission really since the beginning of October, and you defeated 4 conference teams, some from the West as well. Talk about winning those games against the other division.
I think they're very important because we needed to see those teams. So once we enter conference tournament, we're not surprised. Prairie View, a very strong team. Grambling, very athletic, and Southern as well, very strong, very athletic, just a little bit on the small side. But Prairie View, that was a tough match for us. I'm just pleased that we pulled it out in 5 sets.
And you talked all year about the resiliency of your team in different times, their growth process and maturing in matches such as the Prairie View match where you were down 2-1.
Yes, we were. One thing I have always been able to count on with this particular team this season is that they're never give up. They don't quit. And so that's the thing. I think as long as we as coaches can keep encouraging them, can keep giving them instructions and different strategies to apply to our situation in the match, they'll keep trying to apply it and, you know, the ball bounced our way that match.
Among the strong performances last weekend, Amber Bennett, Mylon Marshall earning SWAC Player of the Week honors once again.
Yes, Amber was also named MVP of that tournament. But being home, having her home crowd, Amber has so many fans there, you would have thought it was our home crowd. It was pretty exciting. And Myla has shown up every match. Our middles are a force to be reckoned with. But not to take anything away, our right sides are very dominating also. It's just that people tend to remember the middles. But watch LaToya Ellington and watch Tierra Kelly. They are a force to be reckoned with on the right side.
Let's take a look at last weekend's highlights versus Southern. White, among the highlights throughout this season, career highlight for Louisa Grizz, more than 1,000 digs in her career.
Yes, she reached that milestone this past weekend, and I think she went in knowing that she was a matter of numbers away from reaching that, but to do whatever was best for the team. And she went in and she was very disciplined. I think we had kind of lost a little bit of disciplinary positioning in defense, and we were able to get that back, and I think that's going to be huge for us this Friday night against Jackson State.
You mentioned the discipline. Talk about what her role as a senior can bring to a team that's still growing and maturing.
The great thing about Louisa is, although she's behind the scenes, nothing can happen without Louisa. That first ball contact is huge. But the one thing I do know that the team look for is leadership. If Louisa's calm, they're calm. She are our emotional leader.
You alluded to it just a moment ago. This weekend's huge matchup with Jackson State. Last year, five epic matches with them. Talk about this weekend's match.
Oh, this is a huge match for us, with them being the winning SWAC champions from last season. But for us, they're just another opponent on the other side of the net. But I do know we have to go in, we have to remain disciplined, and we have to stick to our plan. And the girls have been training with that in mind. We know that they have a returning senior who is a middle hitter, Paige Williams. She'll play middle, but she'll play right side probably against us. She's been playing right side for the last couple weeks. So just scouting some videotape, they have made huge changes. They are a big team. I'm not sure if they're as seasoned as they have been in the past.
Volleyball SWAC Showdown this upcoming weekend, Alabama State versus Jackson State. We'll have highlights for you next week here on the Hornet Sports Report. Up next, we'll have the compliance tip of the week, and we'll take you inside the buzz.
Helping wounded heroes start anew, creating new DNA technologies to help keep our communities safe. If you haven't seen ASU lately, you haven't seen ASU. Alabama State University has expanded academic opportunities with new degrees in forensic chemistry, prosthetics and orthotics, applied technology, and microbiology. ASU students and faculty are at the forefront of cutting-edge research that is changing lives. If you haven't seen ASU lately, you haven't seen ASU.
Welcome to this week's Compliance Tip of the Week. What is the difference between an extra benefit and preferential treatment? An extra benefit is a special arrangement by a university employee or representative of athletics interests to provide a student athlete or a student athlete's parent or legal guardian a benefit that is not generally available to other Alabama State University students and their relatives, or is not expressly authorized by NCAA legislation. Preferential treatment occurs when an institution does not have knowledge of the treatment, benefit, or services being provided to the individual. Remember, compliance is everyone's responsibility. Ask before you act. For more information, or if you have questions, email us at compliance@alasu.edu. That's this week's Compliance Tip of the Week.
The Alabama State soccer team has opened conference play 2-0 for the first time in the program's history, both wins coming on the road. ASU won at Alcorn State 5-0 on Friday and at Valley 2-1 on Sunday to win for the fourth straight time and improve to 7-6 overall. ASU has allowed just 2 goals during its 4-game winning streak, and head coach Jody Smith is very pleased with how his team is playing.
Well, certainly, you know, getting 3 wins in a week is fantastic. We scored a lot of goals, did a lot of nice things offensively early in the week, and then defensively we had a really good game against Alcorn and Valley. So for us to get started with the opening conference play with 2 wins on the road is big for us.
The Alabama State men's and women's cross-country teams swept last weekend's event at the Birmingham Southern Invitational. Freshman Andrew Cuckoo and Tyree Newton set the tone as the ASU men took the top 4 spots. The women's team followed suit as Artrea Lissane and Paige Rankin led the Lady Hornets, who took the top 5 spots.
Well, we definitely were excited about the win this weekend. The men coming back with a victory, the women coming back with a victory. Still got a lot of work to do. We had individual champion Artrea Lissane. She was the overall race winner, which was good. Anytime we can get a win during the season, it's always a plus for the program.
The Hornet basketball teams have completed their first week of fall practice. The Lady Hornets are building toward the regular season opener versus Troy on November 8th in the Dunn-Oliver Acadome. Head coach Frieda Freeman-Jackson has focused her team on the defensive side of the ball, placing a heavy emphasis on defensive principles in the opening week.
I felt the first week of practice was very productive. The young ladies was learning a lot, trying to get adjusted to Division I basketball as far as the freshmen coming in, understanding the level in which we like to play. And one of the things that we're really emphasizing, and I emphasize every year, but I didn't feel that we did a good job on last year, and that's playing defense. And I'm making sure we play defense without fouling. A lot of the young ladies felt that if they stopped the play, that was defense. So we spent a lot of time as far as what I shell drill, all the different principles of a man-to-man, and making sure all the young ladies understand what they need to do if they happen to get in a game. So it was really rewarding. At the end of the week, we decided to have a scrimmage to see where we are and where we needed to go. But for the most part, I thought it was very productive.
The men's team is preparing for its season opener at Illinois the same night. With a bevy of new players on the roster, head coach Lewis Jackson has enjoyed the opening week of practice and likes the effort and intensity of his players, many of whom are still going through the growing pains of learning the Hornet system.
Well, it's been a very exciting week. We've seen a lot of energy, you know, a lot of enthusiasm. Guys are really, you know, coming in and working hard and trying to get the things accomplished that we're trying to give them. You know, it's been a little tough because, you know, it's kind of like starting all over with the teaching process and things like that. We had 5 returning players. You know, only 2.5 of those guys really got a lot of playing time. So it's been difficult, but it's been also exciting because the guys are trying so hard to do what we're asking them to do.
Helping wounded heroes start anew, creating new DNA technologies to help keep our communities safe. If you haven't seen ASU lately, you haven't seen ASU. Alabama State University has expanded academic opportunities with new degrees in forensic chemistry, prosthetics and orthotics, applied technology, and microbiology. ASU students and faculty are at the forefront of cutting-edge research that is changing lives. If you haven't seen ASU lately, you haven't seen ASU.
The hard work. The sweat. The pain. It all comes down to this. Who will rise as others fall? Who will lead victorious? Houston will never be the same. The Battle of the Bands and the 2013 Toyota SWAC Football Championship. Who will be victorious on Judgment Day?
Welcome back to the Hornet Sports Report. Joined now again by head coach Reggie Barlow and also during the street coach, the offense has gained almost 500 yards a game, averaging more than 42 points during that time.
Well, Coach Kice and the offensive staff, they're really putting our guys in good positions to make plays. You talk about Isaiah Crowell and Malcolm Sires that are really a good combination of running the ball. Our offensive line have been doing a good job of moving people off the line of scrimmage. And the running game has allowed us to, you know, take shots down the field. And last week, Duhart threw a really nice pass to DeMario Bell, which gave us a big play and a touchdown. So kudos to our offensive coaches, our defensive coaches. These guys are doing a good job of game planning against our opponents and allowing our guys to go out and make plays.
This week, big matchup versus Prairie View. Very similar offensive styles. I think we're 1-2 in scoring offense as well as total offense. Talk about what you've seen from them on tape.
Prairie View's offense is very, very exciting. Their offensive coordinator does a great job there. They are fast-paced. And when I say fast, they're going really fast. And this game here is going to be a tell of how fast can we get lined up. Can we be physical in the slots where we redirect the wide receivers? And then we got to get off blocks on the edge because they do a lot of bubble screens, quick throws to their receivers and running backs. Their quarterback is completing at a high percentage. So we have our work cut out for us. It's going to be a huge challenge for us. Hopefully we could slow their offense down by being able to run the ball on our offense, which will keep them off the field. But it's going to be a real challenge. They're playing with a lot of confidence right now. I think they're coming off of maybe 3 or 4 victories themselves, and it's just going to be a big-time game for us.
Defensively, they're very opportunistic as well. Lead the conference in takeaways. What do you see on that side of the ball?
Well, the thing that I see on their defense is they run to the ball, and when you have 8 to 9 guys that are consistently running to the ball, then if it comes loose, then you're going to have an opportunity to get it. If there's a tip ball and you got guys running to the ball, you're going to have an opportunity to get it. So their defense is playing really good. And now they're giving up some points, which I think, you know, would give us an opportunity to have some success, hopefully running the ball and throwing it. But they are getting turnovers. Their linebackers are combative and fast, and they run to the ball. So we got to make sure we're protecting it.
As we take a look at this week's SWAC schedule, and Coach, clearly this is the game of the week. When you have two teams that are very evenly matched, what gives?
Well, it always comes down to can you run it and can you protect it? And, of course, you got to win the special teams battle. You got to have positive field position. You got to make field goals if you're in field goal situations. If you're in the red zone, you got to come away with touchdowns as opposed to field goals. And they've shown and they've done a good job in scoring touchdowns. So we got to make sure that we're gap control defense, that we're covering our gaps. Offensively, we have to make sure that we're running the ball and getting explosive plays in our running game. And then when there's times where we need to take shots down the field with our receivers, then we need to do that. But should be a really good game. They're a very well-coached team, playing with a lot of confidence. They're in a similar predicament as us. You know, neither one of us can stand to have a loss. So should be a real exciting game, a lot of offense, and hopefully we can come out on top.
You talk all week, and you talk for several weeks with your team about it being a playoff game. You mentioned Prairie View in a similar situation. They're chasing Southern in the West. We're chasing Jackson in the East. When you have that true big game, how exciting is it to be a part of a game like that?
Well, it's a blessing to have a game of that magnitude and to have it on your campus and to have a playoff atmosphere, because you know you have to have the approaches. If you don't take care of business, then there's no tomorrow. Because, you know, your chances become a little slimmer. But we're building it up because it is a big game to us. It's a big game for them. Our student-athletes and our coaches have to understand that every play has to have a life of its own, and we have to really be invested in the vision of that and make sure that we're making plays.
SWAC Showdown on Saturday at the new ASU Stadium, Alabama State, taking on Prairie View at 1 p.m. Remember, it's our Think Pink game, so wear pink with your ASU gear. If you can't make it out, watch all the action live online at BamaStateSports.com. Thanks for joining us on this week's edition of the Hornet Sports Report. As always, go Hornets!